sharing the song this morning.
Yeah. Amen.
2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. 2 Peter 1 and 3. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3.
Truth is, We are empowered with everything we need to, in fact, live a life for Jesus Christ. Peter wrestles with this as he begins to stand in great, firm, strong contention. As he wrestles with this, writing this second epistle to Christians all around Asia Minor. This letter was not penned to one particular church, if you will.
Well,
this letter was penned to all Christians throughout the area of Asia Minor.
Yeah.
When Peter would write these circular letters, he would send them with a messenger who would go from city to city, town to town, standing up boldly and aloud, reading the words that Peter has penned.
Yeah.
He not simply writes one letter that has been recorded in our Bible. This is his second letter that he began to circulate all throughout Asia Minor.
Yeah.
He pens this letter, number one, to remind Christians of what they already knew. He wanted to bring to their attention what was previously taught unto them.
Yes.
They already knew the ways of the Lord Jesus Christ by the teaching of the Apostle Paul, and even by way of this Apostle Peter. But he understood that there are times along life's journey when each and every Christian needs self-reminder.
Yeah.
And if we'd be honest on this morning, we would be able to testify that Peter's contention is true.
Yes,
that we all at times need reminders.
Yeah.
And not just reminders because we have memory issues. Not just reminders because we wrestle with memory loss, if you will. Because you can have your complete and whole mind.
Yeah.
And at times, God needs to nudge you on your shoulder and remind you of some things that he has predestined for your life.
That's right.
I know I got a witness this morning that can testify that there are times when, in fact, I did need a reminder from the Lord that everything was going to be all right. There were times along life's journey where, in fact, I did need a reminder from God that what he has in store for me is still yes and is still amen. Peter writes this letter because Christians, he would contend, needed reminders.
Yeah.
He wrote this letter, secondly, my brothers and sisters, because he desired to record Christian doctrine.
Yeah.
He understood that his execution was now, and he wanted his teaching to outlive him. He understood the power of Christian doctrine. And he understood that Christian doctrine should go beyond his own mortality. He understood that there were some things in him that needed to be placed in the archives, if you will. And so he writes this because he wanted all of the Christian ways that Jesus had predestined for our journey to be written out so that even when he leaves the earth, what God has established will still in print, if you will.
Yes, sir.
And I will contend, my brothers and sisters, on this wonderful Sunday morning that you and I ought to understand the importance of allowing some things to outlive us.
That's right.
When you understand the importance of the work of Christ, you understand that it's bigger than you.
Yeah.
And that even when you fade away from the scene, there are some things that Christ has placed inside of you that you ought to leave in the hearts and on the minds of everybody around you.
Yeah.
We like to call it legacy, if you will.
That's right.
We like to say that we want to leave a legacy. Well, in essence, Peter desired to leave not simply a legacy about himself, but a legacy about Christian doctrine.
Yes, sir.
Because when you understand, my brothers and sisters, the importance of what God has placed inside of you, you're not so concerned with it stopping with you.
All
right.
That could be an issue, Deacon Cochran, for some in this day and age, because they lack all the glory, honor, and credit for themselves. That could be an issue, Sister Clark, for some in this day and time, because there are some who lack all of the glory, honor, and praise for themselves. But when you understand that it's not about you receiving the glory, you understand that it's worth putting out there, leading for somebody else to be able to continue the work of him that has sent us.
Yeah.
Peter writes this letter, my brothers and sisters, to remind them of what the Lord has predestined for their lives. It was a letter of remembrance. It was a letter to record, if you will, Christian doctrine. And then Peter begins to write this epistle. He wrote it, if you will, because he desired to reinforce his contention that the only reason he was able to stand so strong on this doctrine to the end, that he wanted to record it and wanted to constantly remind the Christian of it, is because he suggests that he was an eyewitness.
Yes,
in other words, Peter understood that they needed to hear this so much. They needed to be reminded of it so much. And it needed to come from him, Peter, because Peter suggests that he was an eyewitness to everything that he was talking about. Here's how Peter contends it. He says, "For we have not followed cunning devices, divisive fables, but when we made known unto you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus, but we were eyewitnesses of his majesty."
Yeah.
In other words, Peter suggests that the reason I'm telling y'all all of this and want y'all to live on all of this is because I ain't talking about nothing I heard. I'm talking about what I seen with my own eyes.
All right.
He pushed it further and suggests that he seen it with his own eyes. He eyewitnessed it, if you will, when Jesus was being baptized. And he suggests, it's right there in chapter 1, that he saw the heavens open up and heard the voice of God the Father declare that this is my Son in whom I am well pleased. He said, I was an eyewitness when Jesus went to the mountain of transfiguration and God began to speak to him. And I would suggest, my brothers and my sisters, that you and I also are eyewitnesses.
That's right.
We have seen the Lord's handiwork on a daily basis.
Yeah.
And this is Peter's contention that the reason he's writing all of this, he wants them to stand firm on this and in this, is because he's seen it with his own eyes.
Yeah.
It's the reason, my brothers and sisters, that Peter begins to open up this letter with this strong contention that in fact every Christian without shadow of doubt does have everything that they need. That's what it says, it's what it states, and that's why he states it. Because he's seen it, he heard it, he wants to record, wants them to know it, and this is why he says that you are not without anything you need to live a godly life for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah, yeah.
Here's how Peter says it. Peter says it this way: his divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of him who called us by his own glory.
Yeah.
In other words, Peter begins to suggest that every child of God has been infused with everything they need to live a Christian life. Anything you need to live a life for. suggest that you'll be a top 10 theological faker.
Well,
it's not to suggest that you would know all of the theology and every doctrine there is to man, but the suggestion is that you'll crack open your Bible and begin to learn more and more about Jesus. That you won't just take what you heard, that you'll read it for yourself. That you won't just read it for yourself, but you'll experience it for yourself. And one day I went to a meeting and the song wasn't right, but something got a hold of me. And ever since that day, my life has no longer been the same. And I can testify that he touched me. And now I know that he's alive and doing good with me. You got to know something about Jesus.
Yeah.
What do you know about him? What you know about the Lord?
Well.
What you know about the Lord?
Yeah.
And that's his suggestion that if you and I are going to live a godly life, tap into what he's already placed inside of us to live for him. The suggestion is you got to have knowledge of the Lord Jesus.
Yes, sir.
But not only must you have knowledge of the Lord Jesus, secondly, you got to allow your knowledge of him to be infused with the divine.
Yes.
Allow your knowledge of him to be infused with the divine.
Yeah.
Listen at how Peter suggested. Peter says, don't just know him, but here's what he says. His divine power has given us everything we need.
Yes.
To live a life of godliness through the knowledge. In other words, it's not just about knowledge. It's about allowing his divine power to be infused with the knowledge you have.
Yeah.
In other words, you Yeah.